Welcome to Electricity Section 4. I'll try to be quick with this one because I know you don't like to listen to me ramble on and on. Key concepts we're going to learn in this unit are: what is Ohm's law? What are basic features of an electric circuit? We'll focus on both series and parallel circuits. How many paths can currents take in a series in a parallel circuit? Ohm's law. In the 1800s, George Ohm did experiments to demonstrate how current, voltage, and resistance are related. What he found out was, changing the voltage in a circuit changes the current, but will not change the resistance. He concluded that conductors and most other devices have a constant resistance, regardless of the applied voltage. Calculating with Ohm's law. The relationship between resistance, voltage, and current is summed up in Ohm's law. Ohm's law says that the resistance is equal to the voltage divided by the current. Here's the formula: resistance equals voltage divided by current. The units are in ohms equal volts divided by amps. Let's use this formula. What happened to the current if voltage is doubled and resistance is unchanged? Look at the formula. What happens to the current if the voltage is doubled and the resistance is the same? The voltage is doubled without changing the resistance, then current is doubled as well. What are some features in a circuit? All circuits have the same basic features. One, they have devices that are run by electrical energy. Two, a circuit has a source of electrical energy. And three, electric circuits are connected by conducting wires. Let's take a closer look at each of these. Number one, circuits have devices that are run by electrical energy. Radios, computers, light bulbs, etc. are all devices that transform electrical energy to some other form, whether it's light or heat, but they transform electrical energy to some other form. Light bulbs and fans resist the flow of electric current and are therefore represented as resistors in a circuit. You honestly need a resistor in a circuit, because what'll happen is what's called a short circuit. And if there's nothing to resist that flow to slow it down, then you'll short circuit, or it can catch on fire. And that's the cause of many house fires. A circuit has a source of electrical energy. That was number two. Batteries, generators, and electric plants all supply energy to circuits. Energy is the ability to do work. The source of electrical energy makes charges move around a circuit, allowing the device to do work. Three, electric circuits are connected by conducting wires, meaning made of a conductor, typically copper or some other form of metal. The conducting wires complete the path of a current. They allow charges to flow from the energy source, the battery, etc., to the device that runs on electric current and back to the energy source. A switch is often included to control the current. You can turn it off or turn it on. You can turn on or off the device by closing or opening the switch. Notice that all parts of the circuit are shown in this diagram. Each part is represented by a simple symbol. Arrows indicate the direction of current, positive or negative, on the battery, which indicate positive or negative symbols. So check out that diagram below. The direction of the current in this example is it's going from the positive end of the battery through the conducting wires to the resistor, which is the light bulb, back to the negative end of the battery. Let's look at what a series circuit is. If all parts of an electrical circuit are connected one after another along one path, then we call it a series circuit. So check out the diagram below. You'll see that there is one end of the battery connected to one side of the bulb, the other side of that bulb connected to the other side of the next bulb. That is in a series circuit. In a series circuit, there's only one path for the current to take, meaning if one bulb goes out, all of the bulbs will go out as well. This used to be how our Christmas trees were wired, and it was such a big deal to try to figure out which bulb went out because none of the bulbs would light up. Advantage to a series circuit is they're very simple to design and to build. Major disadvantages: if you have light bulbs connected along a series circuit and one bulb goes out, they all go out. There's no other path for that current to take. Another disadvantage: light bulbs become dimmer the more bulbs you add. So you will find out that the more bulbs you add to a series circuit, the less energy each bulb will get. Why? A light bulb is a type of resistor. If you add more bulbs, resistance increases. How do we measure current? An ammeter is a device used to measure current. If you want to measure the current through some device in a circuit, an ammeter should be connected in a series with that device. Now let's talk about a parallel circuit. In a parallel circuit, the different parts of the circuit are on separate branches. There are several paths for the current to take. So if you look in the diagram, you'll see that one end of the bulb of the battery is connected to one side of the bulb. That side of the bulb is connected to the same side of the next bulb. The same side of that bulb is connected to the same side of the third bulb. So on with the other side. There are two separate sides there. What happens if a light burns out on a parallel circuit? If there's a break in one branch, charges can still move through the other branches. If one bulb goes out, the others will stay on. Switches can be added to each branch to turn light on and off without affecting the other branches. What happens to the resistance in a parallel circuit when you add a branch? Overall, resistance actually decreases, the opposite of when you add a bulb to a series circuit. Why? Think about it this way. Imagine blowing through a single straw. The straw resists the flow of air so that only a certain amount of air comes out. However, if you use two straws, twice as much air can flow. The more straws you have, the more paths the air has to flow. The air encounters less resistance. As new branches are added to a parallel circuit, the electric current has more paths to follow, so the overall resistance will decrease. Remember, for a given voltage, if resistance decreases, the current will increase. The additional current travels along each new branch without affecting the original branches. If you add branches to a parallel circuit, the brightness of the light bulb does not change. Measuring voltage. When you measure the voltage of a device, the voltmeter and the device should be wired as a parallel circuit. A voltmeter is a device used to measure voltage. Let's talk about household circuits. The circuits in your home are parallel circuits. Electrical energy enters your home through heavy-duty electrical wires. They have very low resistance. parallel branches extend out from the heavy-duty wires to wall sockets and then to appliances and lights in each room. Switches are installed to control one branch of the circuit at a time. Usually, the voltage in most households is about 120 volts.